again. It's now week 7, day 2 of I'll Write Your Novel in 9 Weeks, which is exactly what you're doing. Today, I, Little Willie Sockspear, will be talking about perfectionism. Fortunately for you, for me, for all writers, we live in an imperfect world, and there's no such thing as a piece of perfect writing. You've never written anything perfect, have you, Beale?
No.
You've written things that have been all right.
Yes.
And you've written things that have been published.
Yes.
You've written things that have gotten good reviews and people say, well, that's nice.
Yes.
Were they perfect?
No.
Well, then, I think you should be aware, dear novelist, that now that your manuscript has some size to it, some heft, some weight, it may be tempting to think, I should start going back over this and making it better. No.
Are you saying no?
Well, yes, I'm saying no. What did I just say? I said no. Not yet. There will be time for self-editing later. And when that day comes, don't confuse I can make this different than it is with I can make this better than it is. There's always tinkering that can be done, and there must come a point where, in the words of Pontius Pilate, I'm being a little bit religious here, Bill. In the words of Pontius Pilate, quod scripsi scripsit, what I have written, I have written.
You're going to quote Pontius Pilate in How to Write a Novel.
Oh, it's a good quote, Bill. It's good for writers to keep that in mind. This is being said by someone who spent a week, I'll be honest with you, I'm very honest, obsessing Romeo and Juliet. Cross out. No. Juliet and Romeo. No. Romeo and Juliet. No. Cross out. Juliet and Romeo. You get the idea.
Any honest professional writer will tell you that once a piece reaches a professional level, any over-tinkering only causes damage. And once a piece is published, the writer always sees things he or she wishes could be changed, adjusted, edited,
nudged, nuanced, axed. In part, that's why not a few professionals don't read their own work once it's published. Your novel, dear novelist, will not be perfect.
Your novel may be very, very good.
Your novel, even if it is not very, very good, is still a novel you have written. And that is a tremendous accomplishment. Don't let being imperfect stop you. It never stopped Bill. You know, now I say that out loud. I think you could be a poster boy of, look, imperfect writer. Did you ever think about that, Bill? You could really help people.
I could.
Don't let being imperfect stop you from completing your novel or from taking pride in that accomplishment, because it is an accomplishment.
That's right, Willie. That's very true. Tomorrow, I'm going to be talking about dealing with naysayers.
Naysayers? That's another good word, Beale. Can't use that too many times, can you? In a single book.
Not too many.
All right. Tomorrow, Bill will be talking about naysayers. Till then.